Raising Voices has partnered with Boda Boda riders to help fight violence against children. Many of them will be wearing reflector jackets with tiny hats for awareness. So next time you board one dressed like this, just know it's all for a good cause. And because their business affects many, it's our politicking topic for today.
That the police is the crucial stakeholder and also a partner.
Working together with the Uganda police and Boda Boda transport providers, Raising Voices is creating a Kampala and a Uganda where all children enjoy their rights, feel safe, and can fully exercise their potential to realize their aspirations. As part of their media campaign to prevent violence against children, Raising Voices produce material to engage people in dialogue and action. In this line, reflector jackets branded with a heart-shaped sticker carrying the message, "What are you doing to prevent violence against children?" have been given out to engage Boda Boda riders. They will be engaging their passengers in conversations about the cause.
We believe that Boda Boda riders provide a valuable transport service to the general public. And we thought that would be an opportunity for us to communicate to the traveling public. As we know, when people sit on a boda, they're usually an individual and a boda rider. So we thought if we had a reflector jacket that had our message, that then it would spark a conversation between the two people. And the conversation would center around how we treat our children, you know, what violence against children is, you know, what we can do. Because at the end of the day, we can't be in people's homes, we can't be in people's lives all the time. But people themselves, once they talk to each other, they can find a way of how they can act.
Boda Boda riders provide vital daily transport services to the general public. And Raising Voices believes they can pull stakeholders who are their passengers to be part of the struggle.
I was also happy to find me here to fight against child violence. I'm also a person like their parents.
I'm a parent to children, they are far. To beating children without any reason, that is very bad to the what?
The police are seen as important stakeholders in as far as securing the rights, safety and well-being of children is concerned. The Assistant Inspector General of Police revealed that the cases of violence against children are still rampant in some parts of the country.
We registered 2,790 cases. Then we have also child desertion. Find like people deserting children. They leave them at home and they are in rented houses. Somebody decides to disappear. And child abuse. Children stealing like a piece of meat, a coin. These were 1,123 cases that we registered in the whole year. And as I earlier said, still, Lira district was leading when it came to missing children. It had 154 cases, followed by Mukono with 148. Then Busia 118, Sese 114, CPS Kampala with 112 cases. Child abuse still was high in Lira with 86 cases, followed by Entebbe Division, which is in Wakiso District, just 60 cases. Then Hoima District with 49 cases. Jinja, 47 cases, and MPG with 45 cases.
At least 300 calls are received every day related to such cases.
I do coordinate all cases of child abuse that relate to Uganda police. If cases are relating to police, I call and coordinate with all other police officers in all stations countrywide so that we can sort out all these cases of child abuse which are done on our children.
Also concerned are university students who agree more needs to be done to ensure children are protected against violence.
For example, we need to do a lot of education on that. By going to schools, we can put a team to go into schools, tell the children that please, this is your right. You have the right to education. You have a right to this. In order to see that these children know their right.
The parents, they have a lot to do. They have to nurture their children in the right way. They have to do each and every possible to make sure that their children are not in danger.
Hundreds of bodaboders receive the protective jackets. They come from different parts of the country like Kabarole, Lira and Luwero. Most of them are cyclists based in Kampala. These reflective jackets will equally help them for their own safety while on the road. But to Raising Voices, it is the message against violence against children that matters. This report by Semazi Simon for PM Land.
The good and bad stories of the day, the Waki and Dope. The Waki goes to violence against children. This is from the story about Raising Voices, working with border borders in Kampala to raise awareness. And the DOP goes to teams participating in the University Football League. All the best in your games. May the best man or men win.
The streets is watching.
You are watching PM Live.
About guild presidents, what qualities must they possess? Let's connect on this. Thanks for your company. That's it for today. I'm Razia Athman. I'll see you later.
PM Live was brought to you by GIIT.
For more information, visit us at Haruna Towers in Wandigea Kumbiri on Bombo Road or contact the principal on 0702-516-354 or the director on 0776-945-602, or you can visit us on our website on www.giit.se.ug.